Apple have just updated their Reminders app, and what they've done is created something rather special. Hello and welcome to this very special episode of my Working With series. What I'm going to be doing over the next three videos is taking you into the new Apple's Reminders app and taking you through the steps of building your own system within that app. Now, because I know many of people out there are not interested in buying expensive to-do list managers and notes app. They just want to use the apps that come built in to their phone, iPhone, iPad, or their Mac computer. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to start us off with the Reminders app because it's brand new, a lot of new features in there, and it is actually rather special. So before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this episode, then please hit that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and would like to get all the latest tips and tricks on time management, productivity and goal planning, then please hit that subscribe button. Okay, let me take you into Reminders app on Mac OS Catalina and show you how to set it up. Well, hello and welcome to Apple's new Reminders application. And it is a huge update to the previous Reminders app. And the previous app, to be perfectly honest, I always struggled to make it really functional. And I guess that's because Apple never really gave it any love. But I can promise you now, Apple have given this some proper love. Okay, so let's get started with this top left-hand corner. We've got a search box up at the top. I have no tasks or reminders in here right now, so obviously I'm going to be searching for nothing. I've got a today view here, which is for all my lists, tasks that would be set for today. I have scheduled tasks. These are all scheduled, and it will show you the dates that they're scheduled. I have these are what's called smart filters, by the way, and these smart filters will also show me my all the tasks that I have, as well as my flagged tasks. So that can be very, very useful for when you're doing like a review or something like that. So the main part of this is where we have what's called my list. Now, when you open up Reminders for the first time, you're going to have this one called Reminders. Now, I'm going to recommend that you change that immediately because Reminders is too generic. What you really want to be doing is calling this inbox. So let's call that inbox, and that's done. So now we've created an inbox. Now you can leave that as red and you can leave this icon if you wish. However, one of the things that Apple have done is given us the option, if we click on show info, you can now click on here and you can change the color. So I'm going to change that to orange. And I'm going to give this, I can never make up my mind because it doesn't give me an inbox as such. It's a shame, but I'm going to give this the computer icon just for now, just for sake. So there we go. So I'm going to hit that. As you see, it's now changed to orange. Now, when you're setting this up for the very, very first time, what I suggest you do is you now create three groups. Now, to create a group in Reminders, we go up to File and New Group. The first one you want to do is Routines. And if you've read my book, Your Digital Life 2.0, you'll know all about routines. Now, one of the things that I always do is I always create my categories like folders or groups in capital letters. It just helps me to see to tell me this is a category, it's not a project. I'm going to create another one called Work. And again, I'm only going to put that in capital letters. And I'm going to create a further one called Personal. Okay, so we've got the three groups in there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to move my inbox, and you can just drag this up to the top here. So that's now up at the top, and I've got my routines, work, and personal there. Now you can go further for those of you guys who are much more advanced in to-do list managers. And of course, you can create areas of focus, categories of improvement, whatever you want to create down here. I'm just going to show you how to set up the basic structure. It's up to you how you want to take this to the level that works for you. So the next thing that you'd probably want to do is to create your first list, because we want to see how this all works. So let's create a list, and I'm going to call this, and it's coming under personal, so I'm going to call this my winter holiday. And so there we go, because we're in October now, so winter holiday is coming. Again, what I'm going to do is hit return, and then I'm going to do control click on winter holiday, show information, and we're going to change this to, I'm going to give it green, and I think we saw we've not got any skis there, have we? So I'm going to give that the plane, and I'm just going to correct my little tiny little typo there. So there we go. Now, one of the things that I always do is I, for projects, I put those in normal caps. So for categories, or in this case, the folders or groups, I'm putting those in capital letters, so it gives me a clear view, and all projects are going to come under my, like in this case, winter holiday. Now, for those of you wondering, what do you do in the routines? Now, the routines is actually quite a simple one. All we're going to do is under routines, we're going to create daily, and I'm going to add weekly, and I create monthly. Now, this is just something that I do, because what I want to do is I like to keep these out of the way, and so I can put this into my routines. So weekly goes into routines, and monthly goes into routines. Just need to set see, you can see it's very easy to reorganize these. And those are in like that. So now, do I want to keep my routines as blue? Then, okay, I'll keep those as blue. I can go into here again. I can click on control on daily, show info, and I can decide what icon I want to use for this. I don't know if there's anything particularly in there that I would say I want to use as an icon, but let's just say we will, oh, it's very difficult to make a decision. Oh, how terrible it is. So I'm just going to give that the sunshine. okay. And you can do the same for weekly. You can create, show the info. You go in there. You can do, I'm going to keep them all the same. Done. And we're going to keep that as blue. And we may as well do monthly as well. So it's control click and show info and change that to the star. There we go. So that's all done. So you can add your, for those of you who know my system, you know that if you've read the Your Digital Life 2.0, or you've taken the Your Digital Life 2.0 online course, details of which will be in the show notes, you know all about routines. So I'm going to leave them for there for now. The one that I want to really show you right now is how now to get your tasks into winter holiday. So what we've got here is, let's go into the first one. All we have to do is you can tap Command New, and that will give you straight up here. So ask RK. RK is what I call my short form for my now wife, where she would like to go, this winter. And when you hit return, it's going to add another task in there. So I can do look into best flight deals. Oh, I'm terrible at spelling today. I can then go book flights for winter holiday. And we can then book, find best hotels, etc. So I've given this, I've put in a few tasks in there, and they're all in. So what we can do now is, if you go to that task now, we've got like this little click on here, information. So I can say at a location when messaging a person. So this is a really cool feature that I've not seen. So if I click on that and I can add contact, then I could go and search for, see my, we're going to family. So Rangyong's there. So I can put Rangyong in. So whenever I'm messaging that whenever I'm messaging Rangyong now, all I have to do is that will come up every time I message. Priority, I'm going to give that, you can give it high, low, medium. I'm going to give that a medium. I can add an image, or I can add a URL, but for now that's not. I can also, in this case, so we can go, does she want to go skiing or somewhere warm? question mark. So I've added my little notes, that's done. So that comes up in the task like that. It also gives me the information and it's given me the two green flags. So it's not coming up here as a flagged. Because now, just to show you that, if I change that to a high priority now, and it's going here, I'm guessing this one, if I click that to a high priority, save, and that's not coming up in there either. So flagged, it's not coming up. So, yes. So go back to my list here. So when we go in there, we got all. So it's showing me that all these inboxes are here. There's nothing in there at all. Let's go back to my personal winter holiday. So that's basically how we set up a project in your reminders. Now, in the next episode that I'm going to do on this, I'm going to go into a little bit more detail on some of the things that you can do to set up. But this should get you going right now. So it's giving you a few ideas of what you can do with the new reminders app. I'd also going to show you in the next episode what this all looks like on the iPad, because that's just a really cool way of seeing how everything works. So join me in the next episode. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Thank you for watching this video. Now, if you want to take your productivity to a higher level, then get yourself enrolled in my 2019 edition of Your Digital Life 2.0 online. It is a complete, comprehensive productivity and time management course, and it's a course that will take you to levels of productivity you have only ever dreamt of before. It shows you how to build your very own COD system, collect, organize, and do. It shows you how to create the folder structure, how to build into your goals, into your daily to-do list. It has everything. And not only that, you will get a free copy of Your Digital Life 2.0, the book. You also get a free workbook, and you get access to all the slides that are used in the course. It is incredible value. I want to see you in that course. If you are serious about becoming productivity, then please join me in Your Digital Life 2.0, the 2019 edition. Thank you very much for watching this video.